We have a 2013 World Series champ on the line. He's now doing work with CBS. Great handle on Twitter, too. He's one of the lucky guys, at Middlebrooks on Twitter. Former MLB third baseman. Here's Will.
What?
Yeah, how do you get your last name? That's what I want to know.
Did he start Twitter?
That's exact. At Jack and at Middlebrooks were the first two guys ever on Twitter. Here's Will Middlebrooks. Can you explain that? How'd you get your handle to just be your last name? How'd you pull that off?
You know, I've never actually put a whole lot of thought into that, but you're spot on because there's obviously a ton of people with my last name. So I made it in 2010 or 11, and I guess, I mean, clearly it was just available. I don't know. I didn't like pay for it or anything.
Yeah, I mean, Johnny,
I got underscores and middle initials and all kinds of stuff in my name trying to find it. So, Will, you got me covered big time. Good for you.
Hey, I do what I can. I'm just, you know, I love Twitter, you know, especially right now as much as turmoil going on within baseball. If I try to say anything about baseball, it's just I'm getting shots fired at me. But it's fun. It's fun to interact with everyone.
Well, it's wild, isn't it? Like, and it's not going to stop once we start talking about baseball. It'll get worse. You know, like you start having an opinion on Vladdy moving over to first base, and half the fans want to jump on you, half the fans want to retweet you and support. Like, we're not even into the actual real analysis on Twitter, and people are all fired up. And that's been a big story in Toronto, the fact that Vladdy moved from third to first, and you're familiar with that first position playing third. You know, you watched him last year. His numbers were awful on the stats. The eye test, he failed miserably. He's not a third baseman. He wasn't ever going to develop into one. I just didn't see it happening. I like this move. I don't have an issue with them not delaying it. Get him to first. Get him some reps. Hopefully he can play there. I still think he may be a career DH. We'll find out sooner rather than later. But how do you feel about that move from the Blue Jays?
I think it's a great move. Like you said, he's not your prototypical third baseman, and we know that. We know why he's in the big leagues. We know why he's a professional baseball player. It's his bat, and he can hit. And, yes, look, I think we need to step back and realize there were some pretty lofty expectations last year for a 20-year-old in the big leagues. He was 20. When I was in 20, I was in low A hitting 250. Like, he did better than that in the big leagues, right? And I ended up being a big leaguer for a few years. But he's going to be just fine, guys. Listen, the tools he has at the plate are what 99% of players in the big leagues wish they had. And on top of that, he's got a father who's, you know, we know what his father did in the big leagues. My gosh. I mean, the advantage that he has and a couple of his teammates had were growing up in an MLB clubhouse. And not many people can say they were show kids. I mean, they grew up in a clubhouse. They got to see how the games, the in and outs worked. And, look, I know I'm getting away from your question, but I just wanted to touch on that because that's such an advantage. But
well, three greats, too, right? Like, two of them in the Hall of Fame. And Dante Bichette was nothing to sneeze at either. He was a great player.
Right, exactly. And to answer your question, the move to first. When I played some first base as well throughout my career, and especially, like, the last 3 or 4 years. And when I got to play first base, it felt like a day off. Mentally, it felt like a day off on the defensive side of the ball. For some reason, when you know all you have to do is catch the ball, you don't have to dive in the hole and make a throw or throw the ball 120 feet across the diamond, it takes pressure off of you. And I think he'll be able to take that extra focus and put it more into his offense. And you're going to see a spike in production.
Well, that's really well said, because I never, you know, not having not played baseball, I never quite, I'm like, how much harder can, like, I get that it's harder and not everyone can do it, but like, how taxing can it be mentally? How taxing can third be physically versus first, where at least the ball's coming all the time, you have to keep moving, but you just explained it very well, that it's like a mental reprieve, that it's just that much simpler playing first and third. And I don't think regular fans, people don't play baseball, appreciate how different, because they're both in the corner, you seemingly have to move around the same other than throwing the ball. Why would it be so different? But apparently it is.
Yeah, and you think about all the way up from little league on, it's always the biggest, slowest kid that plays first. Well, Vladdy's still super athletic. You know, he played third base. Was he a good third baseman? There's a reason he's making the move. I get that. But he's going to be on the more athletic side of first baseman. So he will still be a very good first baseman. And I think, like I said, this is going to translate to better offense when it's a less of a mental grind for him.
with longtime big leaguer Will Middlebrooks. 60-game sprint. You know, we're used to 162. It's a marathon, not a sprint. You hear all the cliches thrown around. Now the opposite are being thrown out, but they make a lot of sense. I mean, anything can happen over 60 games. What are you anticipating in terms of craziness? Once we get to game 60, would it be absolutely outrageous to suggest we could have as many as two or three, maybe four teams that make the playoffs that the so-called quote-unquote experts did not predict were going to be there once this thing started?
I mean, well, there's still some teams in baseball right now that have very much separated themselves from the pack. You know, the Dodgers, the Yankees. I mean, even the Twins are starting to do so. The Rays are on the way. I mean, that's what's tough about the Blue Jays right now is they're in somewhat of a rebuild. They're very young, and they're in a division with two teams that could win the World Series. So, and that's not, you know, it's not a knock on Toronto to say, oh, they're not going to contend for a couple years. Not many people would contend with the A's and the Yankees in your division. That's just how it is. But I still think the best teams in baseball are going to win their division. I still think those teams that would win the 162-game season are going to still win the division. I think it's going to help teams like the Chicago White Sox, who they get to play 10 games against the Royals and the Tigers and play the Pirates and Interleague. And those are teams that are projecting a low 20s when it comes to wins, and I would take the under. So it's going to keep teams in the mix longer towards the end of the season, but I think the best teams still win the division.
How about psychologically, Will, where we know if you're one of those lower teams, over 162, like there's no chance that you have to win a playoff spot. But over 60, and we know the Washington Nationals is one of the worst teams in the league through 50 games last year, and they ended up doing quite well. Thank you very much. So, you know, psychologically, do more teams have a reason to believe as they start this short sprint season?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we've seen it. We've seen two or three years ago, the Marlins, who lost 105 games through 162, might have made the playoffs through 50 or 60 games. So you just never know. But like I said, it's so weighted in some of these divisions with the power teams. There's a very few amount of teams. Maybe the White Sox get hot. Maybe the Reds. Let's look at the Reds. They're exciting. They're on the map now. They're just in a very tough division. There's some divisions that are going to come down to game 60 just because they're very evenly matched. But it's going to be exciting. And I wish they had gone with the extended playoff system just for the fans and to give some fan bases who maybe don't get to experience the playoffs a chance to experience the playoffs.
Yeah, I think you're spot on that. I wish they did that as well, but there, you know, there's pushback on everything. So naturally, they couldn't find a way to find some common ground on that. But hopefully, in the future, I think that's where the game is trending.